What a silly dream! Mr. Krabs had to close the Krusty Krab! Like that'd ever happen. I have the feeling today will be like no other day! Now, I wonder where Gary is. I should probably walk him before I go to work. Good morning, Gary! Wait till I tell you about my crazy dream where the Krusty Krab was closed and...
Meow!
Oh, you don't say. You had a dream too?
Meow! 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 Meow!
That something really bad is gonna happen? Huh?
Meow! 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 Meow!
Whoa, that really is bad. Well, I know just the thing to cheer you up. I'll go fetch your favorite fetching stick.
Don't you think your little friend Gary would like to play some fetch?
Yeah, I guess.
Very well. Then move next to his fetching stick and press the action button to pick it up. Then you can carry the stick to Gary and delight him.
You didn't think I was gonna leave for work without a quick game of fetch, did you, Gary? Now come on, boy! Go long! Longer! Longer! What did you dig up outside, boy? There's something written on it. I think it says, Damger, Donut Alpine, or Elsie. I wonder what that means. Well, maybe we should see what's inside. Oh, don't be such a soggy sport, Gary. What harm can there be in just a little peek? Just what I always wanted, a muddy little bottle. Just think of all the fun we can have cleaning it. Here we go.
Who summons me from my endless slumber? I'll have your eyes for appetizers and your insides for dessert, for I am the Flying Dutchman.
Sorry about that. Just hop right back into your bottle and we'll bury you back out in the yard so you can...
Silence! I'll not return to that prison ever again! And what's this? You've gotten into my treasure, have you? Ooh, I hate it when someone messes with my doubloons. Now, what should I do with ye lowly knaves who dared stir me up? Let me consult my rule book on ghostly doings. In the case of accidental discovery and wanton disruption of my booty, the perpetrators must serve for an eternity on my bloody crew. Well, I ain't never been out to sea with a talking cheese block before, but rules is rules, so I gotta take you with me. Are you ready?
Hold on there, Mr. Dutchman, sir. Technically speaking, it was not me who found you. Gary's the one who dug you up.
Ooh, that's a relief. This little varmint looks like he can do 10 times the work. If he can survive my hypnotic spell.
Oh, no, not Gary. That's not what I meant. Take me, not him.
Too late. My decision is made. Now I've got to check on the treasure stashed back on my ship to make sure no one's been spreading that around. But I'll return shortly to pick up my new crewmate. Say your farewells before I return.
Don't worry, Gary. I'll think of something, and it'll be the type of something that will save you. You can bet on it. Oh. Look at this! A bus stop! I wish I could take a long ride on the bus. Just think of all the amazing places outside Bikini Bottom and all the fun things I could do.
Your wish can easily come true. All you need is the right ticket for this bus stop. When you have the correct ticket, jump onto the bench and the bus will stop for you.
I really need to reach that other ledge, but I don't think I have it in me.
Don't be discouraged. You can do it. Press jump. Then you can glide a bit farther if you press jump again before you land.
Who would leave a letter tile sitting around like that? It's as if someone wanted me to find it.
That is no ordinary letter tile. It is a clue. Gather all the letters that spell your name, and you will have enough clues to find a hidden treasure.
Gee, Patrick, is everything okay?
Not okay, not okay! Something fell on my roof and now my TV doesn't work! I can't get up there to fix the thingy and I'm missing all my favorite shows! No!
Oh, that's too bad. I wish there was something I could do to help.
Ah, but there is. You can get up there if you try. Hold the duck button, then press the jump button to reach high places.
What are you waiting for, SpongeBob? I miss you by shows. A real buddy would get up there and make my life complete again.
Oh, barnacles. Alrighty, looks like I found your problem. There's a big thingy on your thingy and it's all bent out of shape. But it looks too big for me to move.
You don't need to move it when you can simply break it apart. Face the container and press the action button to karate chop it.
Woohoo! My TV is fixed! You saved me from thinking, SpongeBob!
Save your gratitude, my jolly pink friend. It's all in a day's work for a sponge such as I. But, maybe you can help me with a problem that I'm having. You see, it all started this morning when Gary and I were playing fetch.
On second thought, who wants to stay at home and watch TV on a day like this? I'm going downtown to see the new construction site. Maybe you can meet me there and we'll play Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy. Last one there's a nematode.
Now that's not very scary. How does Squidward expect to protect his garden with that?
True. It is not scary when it sits still, but it's really something when it moves. Do you see that little fan nearby? You can blow on the fan with your reef blower to activate the mechanism.
Oh, tartar sauce. Clams in the trash again. Looks like Mr. Krabs will have to call the exterminator.
Do not be so hasty, for these clams are just a part of this cycle of life. When a clam shuts its mouth, you can jump onto it and launch very high. Sometimes, valuable things are hidden in high places.
Oh, Mr. Krabs warned me about playing hooky. But they look so fun! Maybe just one quick ride while no one's looking.
Ah, you little troublemaker. Those hooks can be very dangerous. But I promise not to tell if you use your fishing net to hang from them. That's the only safe way to do it.
Join my ghostly crew. No use fighting it. Your fate's been decided. Now looky here what I got for you. That's right. Watch the little sticky.
Gary, where are you, boy? Gary! Why did you take Gary, Mr. Dutchman? Why? No one makes my best friends into pirates, and I mean no one.
Hello, SpongeBob. So nice of you to finally join us.
Squidward! Am I glad to see you. You won't believe what just happened to me and Gary.
I don't have time for another one of your ridiculous tales. Mr. Krabs wants us to get to the Krusty Krab right away so he can tell us some important news.
Important news? Maybe Mr. Krabs is going to announce the Employee of the Month. What are we waiting for?
Beats me. You just keep chattering away, and I'll see you there when you're done.
So that's how it is. Trying to hear the news before me, eh? Well, let's see who can get to the Krusty Krab first.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
Once again, we see that more legs doesn't mean more speed.
And once again, we see that more holes in your head means less stays inside of it.
All right, you two, stop your jabbering. I've got some difficult news to tell you. Business has been very slow lately, so I'm going to shut down the Krusty Krab until it picks up again.
Shut down the Krusty Krab? I think I'm going to faint.
You boys can hang around here or go home, but I can't pay you one way or the other. Sorry.
Well, isn't that just great? I'm going home to think of some ways to pay the bills. So long, SpongeBob.
Jeepers, Mr. Krabs. Why do you think our business is so slow?
No one seems interested in going out anymore. They think it's too much trouble to leave home.
Too bad we can't move the Krusty Krab into their homes.
SpongeBob, that's it! We'll do just that!
Yeah! What is that? Oh, you want to move the Krusty Krab? Should I get a hammer?
Never mind that. I'm going downtown to set things up. You take this bus ticket and meet me there as soon as you can.
So this is downtown Bikini Bottom. How will I ever find Mr. Krabs in such a huge place where the streets never end and the buildings just go on and on and on?
Yoo-hoo! SpongeBob, over here! Glad you finally made it, lad. Between you and me and this here cart, there's no stopping us now!
Just what exactly is your plan, Mr. Krabs?
It's just like you said, SpongeBob. If no one wants to leave home, then we bring the Krusty Krab to them. I'm talking about food delivery. I'll put out a bag filled with patties whenever enough orders come in. You need to grab the bag and get to all our customers before it's too late. There might even be some tip money in it for you.
This sounds like fun, Mr. Krabs.
Great! This delivery is to a single location, 17 Seashell Street. Go to Seashell Street, then look for the 17 on the building. Then drop off the food at the door. Our food is very popular, so watch out for rough characters who might try to take it from you. Now go to it, lad!
I'm ready for the next delivery, Mr. Krabs.
This delivery is a little trickier. There's a building under construction nearby, and it's full of very hungry workers. Find the two workers who placed the order. Some of the other workers might try to take the food from you. Order up!
Halt, villain! Don't try to get away, for I am Barnacle Boy, Super Sidekick!
You really had me going there for a minute, Patrick! Where did you get that great costume?
I mailed in 450 kelp bar wrappers and got both official costumes from the Mermaid Man show!
Oh, you got both costumes? Oh, can I be Mermaid Man? Oh, please, oh, please, oh, please!
Oh, gee, I'd really like to, but I've been so hungry since I ran out of kelp bars. If only I had something yummy to eat. Krabby Patties? I'm saved! Now we can play Mermaid Man for as long as we want! I put your costume in that tent over there, SpongeBob! Watch out, Evil! Here we come!
Another bag of delicious Krabby Patties served up hot. Who wants a slice of this cakewalk now?
This delivery won't be easy at all. Three different parties called from the high-rise apartments. The first address is apartment 9. I wrote down the other two addresses for you. Make sure to visit both buildings. Good luck!
I just need a few more sand dollars, and then maybe I can get Sandy a gift.
Well, this is your last delivery. Four orders have been called in from this neighborhood.
Here's your food. Thanks!
Patrick, did you just deliver food to my customer?
Hiya, SpongeBob! Are you delivering food for Mr. Krabs, too?
Patrick, I am the only one delivering food for Mr. Krabs. Now tell me what you're doing here.
You think you're the only one who can be a delivery boy? Well, I have a job now, too, and it's not my fault that you're slower than me. So if you'll excuse me, some of us have work to do.
Mr. Krabs would have told me if he hired someone else. No, there's something definitely funny going on here, and I'm gonna find out who's behind it.
Nice work, SpongeBob. We've made enough money to call it a day.
Mr. Krabs, did you hire another delivery boy?
Don't be crazy, lad. Why would I hire someone else when I can make you do all the work for nothing? But I'll tell you, if someone was cutting into my business, I'd follow him until I found out what was really going on.
Follow him, huh? That's not such a bad idea.
Just make sure you don't get too close or they'll see that you're following them. Anyhow, I'm gonna pack up this stuff soon and head on home. Thanks for all your help, lad. There's no better feeling than having a full stomach and me pockets loaded with money. And now for a nice long nap in the office.
If it's a long nap you desire, then I can accommodate you.
A customer! Well, step right inside. Place your order.
You got the wrong idea, crustacean. Just look upon this little treasure and let yourself rest. That's right. Sleep.
Luke, there goes your delivery rival. Now is your chance to find out who is behind this. Don't let him get away this time.
Hi, you, SpongeBob?
Tartar sauce.
You will have to be more careful if you don't want him to see you. Don't let him out of your sight, but don't get too close either.
I'm sorry, Mr. Krabs, but all those people who ordered food told me they already got it.
Fool! Worthless lackey!
That's okay. Others will soon phone in their orders and will be ready and waiting to intercept their calls.
Aha! I'm onto your little scheme now, Mr. Krabs. It's all too clear that you're the one who's been trying to put the Krusty Krab out of business.
Hi, SpongeBob. Are you a worthless lackey, too?
Now I'm really confused, Patrick. Why would Mr. Krabs try to put himself out of business?
Because he's a worthless lackey?
Enough! Enough! Silence, you ignorant buffoons!
Plankton!
Plankton?
Of course, you nattering nincompoops. Who else has the intellect to mastermind such a plan? I would have succeeded too if it weren't for your utter incompetence.
Does this mean I don't get that raise?
Let's face it, Plankton. Evil does not pay, or even get very good tips. Your days of impersonating Mr. Krabs are over!
You may have won that round, SpongeBob, but I don't need a disguise to separate your crabby boss from his fortune. Behold! The greatest attraction to ever appear in Bikini Bottom! Chum World! Hey, everyone will spend so much money here, they won't have any left to buy your pathetic crabby patties! Now I'm off to Jellyfish Fields to watch the invertebrates get tangled in nets of torture. Ta-ta!
I hate to admit it, but that Chum World looks kind of fun.
Yeah, fun.
Where did Plankton say he was going?
Jellyfish Fields!
Hey, Squidward. What's with all the stuff on your lawn?
A squid has to pay his rent somehow, so I'm having a little yard sale to make a few extra sand dollars. Now leave me alone so I can read my book.
What you reading?
It's called How to Defeat Evil Spirits, okay? Now please, let me read.
How to defeat evil spirits? That's just what I need! Can I please borrow your book, Squidward?
You can borrow my book after I'm done with it, okay? So look through my yard sale or whatever, but stop asking about my book.
Hey, Squidward, this big acorn sure is making a weird buzzing noise.
Acorn? You mean that hive I got from my cousin on the coast?
No, I mean this big buzzing acorn in the glass case. I bet Sandy would really like this.
Oh, yeah, I bet your little squirrel friend would really like that acorn. Why don't you buy it for her?
Name your price, yard merchant.
I'll sell it to you for 200 sand dollars. Start saving your tip money.
I really need that book to save Gary. I just want to borrow it for a little while. But how will I ever get it away from Squidward?
You must sneak up on him while he's napping so he doesn't wake up.
I'm ready to buy this acorn now, Squidward.
Well, well, maybe I won't have to sit out here all week after all. The acorn is yours. I'm sure Sandy will love it.
How to Defeat Evil Spirits, Chapter 8, The Flying Dutchman. Any poor soul who awakens the Dutchman must suffer his revenge for all eternity. The only defense against the Dutchman's magical powers are his most personal treasures. These are items which he carried close to him while he was alive. Find all 7 of the lost treasures in order to face down the Dutchman once and for all.
That's it! All I have to do is find the 7 lost treasures of the Dutchman to end this once and for all. Barnacles, I thought this would be a challenge. Hiya, Sandy! Boy, am I glad to see you! You won't believe what happened to me and Gary this morning.
Let me guess. Curiosity got the best of you again?
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Well, don't you fret, little varmint. This squirrel knows just the thing to cheer you up. A good old-fashioned karate match. Just step into my arena when you're good and ready. Okay. Now listen up, because I'm going to remind you how this all works. We've got a short amount of time to bust up all this junk in your yard. The person who breaks the most stuff when the time runs out is the winner.
Just tell me which moves are legal, if you have the guts.
I'll teach you a few moves. You can press the action button to karate chop, press the action button a couple of times to chain attacks together, press the action button in the air to do a kick. Got all that? Ready, set, go! I gotta admit, SpongeBob, that was some tussle. You did okay for a sea critter.
Oh, you weren't so bad for a land critter.
Ooh, that plum took all the fire out of me. I'm going home for a nap. Why don't you drop on by my tree dome and pay a visit, okay?
That was sure swell of Sandy to cheer me up. I wish I could do something special for her. I know! I'll give her a present! But what would Sandy like? I love visiting Sandy in her tree dome. Where else in Bikini Bottom can you worry about dying from all this air? That's strange. I don't feel as dry as I usually do, and I don't need my helmet at all. Oh, the ground in here is soaking wet.
SpongeBob! Get your squishy little body over here! Help!
What happened in here, Sandy?
I got all fired up after our karate match and wanted to practice some more, but I guess I got carried away because I accidentally poked some holes in the dome. This place is filling up faster than 11 gallons in a 10-gallon hat.
What can I do to help?
See if you can find something to plug the holes in the dome. You've got to plug all the holes to stop the water from coming in.
Mission accomplished. All the holes are plugged.
Thanks, SpongeBob. You're a real lifesaver. This place will probably stay soaked for days. As for me, I'm going upstairs to dry off. Tarnation! All those holes in my dome made this place wetter inside than out. I could sure use something special to spruce up this old tree. Hey there, SpongeBob. Back so soon? What you got there?
Well, I just thought you might like this. It's a really weird acorn that makes funny noises when you shake it. Maybe you can use it as a decoration for your tree.
Why, isn't this the fanciest doohickey you ever done saw? This will look great on top of my tree. Hold on a sec while I put it up there. SpongeBob! This is no acorn! Get up here right away!
What seems to be the problem, Sandy?
That acorn you gave me is nothing more than a hive filled with angry bees and wasps. Now someone has to get to the top of the tree and get it down.
Let me guess. That someone is bright yellow and kind of square. Okay, I'll see what I can do to get the hive out of your tree. Well, that hive is out of your tree, so, no hard feelings. Right.
That's a good start, but now I've got all these stinging varmints flying around in here. Round them all up. If you do a good job, I might even have a reward for you.
There are no more stingy thingies in your tree dome, Sandy.
That was some mighty fine wrangling, SpongeBob. I'm going inside my treehouse for a rest. See you later, SpongeBob.
Mistress of Mayhem, how long did you think you could hide in here? Prepare yourself for another defeat.
Is that supposed to scare me? I've been practicing since our last match and I've learned some new moves. Now pay attention. We've got a short amount of time to bust up all this junk in my treehouse. The one who breaks the most stuff when time runs out is the winner. Now here are some advanced moves. Hold the duck button, then press the action button to strike in all directions. You got all that? Ready, set, go!
Must contain immense karate powers.
Well, shucks, SpongeBob. That was some tussle.
I've been looking for you.
Sorry, but my yard sale is over. You should have shown up on time if you wanted to buy something.
I never buy what I want. I just take it. And you're what I'm here for. Another member for my ghostly crew.
But according to my book on evil spirits, the Flying Dutchman is only supposed to take the ones who disturb his rest.
But that little snail fella is working out so well, and my old crew is so lazy. Can't we overlook that rule just this once? Just think how nice it will be when you're a member of the Dutchman's crew.
Ah, there's nothing like a little playtime in Jellyfish Fields to make everything right again.
Hey there, young fella. You here for the jellyfishing competition?
Jellyfishing competition? That sounds like fun. Tell me more, old-timer.
My name is Rusty Scupper, and the competition is sponsored by my bait shop. It's been going on for days. The first contestant to gather 100 jellyfish and bring them back here is the winner.
Does the winner get a prize?
Of course! I keep the prizes in my corral. The winner can choose whichever one he wants. That is, except for the racing snails. Those old boys aren't fit to race anymore. Now get out there and start catching some jellyfish.
I want to see Chum World for myself, Plankton. How do I get in?
You would take the bus in Bikini Bottom, but you need a special bus ticket that also works for the ferry. And I don't think an employee of Mr. Krabs is going to get one of those from me.
Even if I want to spend all my sand dollars at Chum World and make you rich?
Nice try, but all those holes in your head must have dried out your brain. I gave special instructions to all my Chum World clowns not to give you a bus ticket. Oh, and if you see one of my clowns here in Jellyfish Fields, tell him to stop fooling around and get back to work!
Patrick, why aren't you jellyfishing with the rest of us? Are you okay?
Oh, hi, SpongeBob. My tummy hurts. I think it was that funny square thing that I ate. I sure wish someone could get it out of my belly. Get out of my belly, square thingy! Whoa, I feel a lot better. Thanks. Hey, look, there's another one of those tasty square thingies. And it's all mine!
You must be one of the clowns from Plankton's Carnival.
Hey, buddy, don't tell Plankton you saw me today, okay? I don't want to get in trouble.
Maybe we can make a deal. I won't tell Plankton where you are if you give me your bus ticket to Chum World.
Give you my bus ticket? Then I would be in real trouble. But I'll tell you what, Squid. If you can defeat me, then you can have the ticket. Okay, I give up. Here's your stinking bus ticket. The bus in Bikini Bottom will take you to Chum World. I gotta find a new line of work.
Like I told you before, it takes 100 jellyfish to win this competition.
Well then, feast your eyes on this stash, Rusty.
We have a winner! Now you can choose one of the prizes inside the corral.
Wanted a Reef Blower 2500? What a great prize!
Not that hunk of junk.
But this is what I want. The Reef Blower that defines Reef Blowers.
Okay, go ahead and try it on to make sure it fits. Stop! My poor snails!
Gee, sorry about that. I've never used one of those before.
From now on, use a changing tent to put on that reef blower, just to be safe. You can press the action button to roll something big with it, or to activate a fan. And some critters are actually afraid of the reef blower, like my poor old racing snails. How will I ever get them back into my corral?
Don't worry, Rusty. I'll herd all your snails back into the corral for you using this.
SpongeBob! Oh, where is he? I'm tired of being alone all the time.
Prepare yourself, pudgy pink one, for you shall soon be part of my pirate crew.
Part of a pirate crew? Oh, goody! I won't be alone anymore.
Okay now. I'm just going to hypnotize you so we can...
What are we waiting for? Let's get going already.
So, just keep your eye on this patty.
Listen, am I going to be part of your crew or not?
Hi, Larry. Where does this bus go?
Everyone knows this is the bus to Goo Lagoon, the land of eternal sun and surf. I'm just waiting for my friend to show up so I can give him my extra bus ticket.
An extra ticket? Can I borrow it for a while? I haven't been to Goo Lagoon in ages.
Sorry, little dude. I only have one extra bus ticket.
Please?
Nope. No can do.
But I just want to borrow it.
Listen, nothing will convince me to give away this extra ticket. Well, maybe for 50 jellyfish, which I can use to make my favorite snack.
Look out, Chum World! Here I come!
You are one tough customer. But Plankton gave me specific orders not to let you into the Big Top.
Listen, clown. We can do this the easy way or the hard way.
Orders are orders, but maybe we could make a deal. I'll light 5 targets nearby, and if you can extinguish them all really quickly, then maybe I could use it as an excuse to leave this door.
Light them up and stand back! What do I need to play this game?
All you need is a good throwing arm to play the porthole plunge. You gotta try to plug a ball in each of the 3 portholes on the side of the ship. Understand? Keep your eye on the anchor and start shooting hoops. That was luck, all luck. I mean, nice job, dear sport. Here's your prize.
How is this game played?
Okay, the inflato game works like this. The balloon is surrounded by 4 buttons. You gotta slam all the buttons really fast to blow the balloon up and pop it. Do you need me to repeat that? Start stomping!
I beat your challenge, clown, so take your stinky breath elsewhere. Come on, shake a fin, move it! Do I just roll around to play this game? I can do that.
The object of Chum Putt is to roll this ball to the top of the course. But you've got to hit all the goals along the way. So, do you want to give it a try? Let's get this ball rolling.
For the last time, I'm not giving away my extra bus ticket.
I'm not here for your measly ticket, Larry. No, I was just taking a long stroll to think of all the ways I can use these jellyfish. There's jellyfish jam and jellyfish jambalaya, candy jellyfish and jelly pot pie, tentacle twists and jelly pops.
I can't stand it anymore. Take the bus ticket and hand over those jellyfish.
Goo Lagoon, the sand, the surf. There is nothing like being at the ocean, except being under the ocean. Gee, Larry, this place is ocean swell. Thanks again for loaning me your extra ticket.
Well, look what the tide washed in. It's that dude who catches jellyfish. Try to keep your distance, okay? I don't want my friends to see us talking together.
Oh, sure thing, Larry. But can you tell me where you got that belt? It's got a really nifty letter tile on it.
You mean my championship belt? I won this at the Goo Lagoon Tough Man Tournament. Now stop talking with me, okay? People might see us.
What if I just sing to you? Then maybe no one will notice. Oh, there! Once were 2 fellas who met on the beach. One needed a belt that seemed out of reach.
That's it. I'm out of here, dude. Maybe I can find some peace and quiet at the lighthouse.
Excuse me, but can I sit on your lifeguard stand?
Of course not. Now beat it, you little wimp.
Hey, old-timer. What's with this pier?
This pier handles all the shipping for Bikini Bottom. We can handle orders of any type or size. Our next shipment is going to be a huge load of magic bottles. Seems like everyone's trying to bottle up that Dutchman on account of his curse. Do you want to order one?
Do you mean I can get one here?
Sure, no problem at all. It costs only 300 sand dollars, tax included. Just let me know when you're ready to pay for your order.
I'd like to order that magic bottle, please. And here's the sand dollars to pay for it.
Your order will be on the next boat, but she won't be able to dock until the lighthouse is active on account of foul weather.
What's wrong with the weather? Seems nice enough to me.
Well, you never heard it from me, but the captain of the delivery boat has actually been having a little eye trouble lately. So he needs the lighthouse beacon to help guide him into dock. The only problem is that the repairs to the lighthouse were never finished. So someone still has to get up there and turn on that beacon.
You again? I already told you I'm not giving up my championship belt. Now stop asking me about it, dude.
I can see that my song needs another verse. Oh, there once were two fellas who met on the beach. One needed a belt that seemed out of reach. It had a big letter that would open a treasure. But the big guy who wore it did not want to remove it.
Tartar sauce! Where can I go to get away from you? Maybe I can hide at that old shipwreck.
All right! I turned on the lighthouse beacon! Is there anything else that has to be done? Anything at all?
That's everything! The boat should arrive any time now. I'll go open the gate. You better get on the end of the pier. You might miss the boat.
I hope I made it in time. Yes, I see the boat now. It's getting closer. Getting closer. Looking good. Not slowing down, but definitely getting closer. Getting really close. Still not slowing down. Too close. Must move legs. Hurry.
There's no reason for me to stick around here now that the pier's demolished. If only I was younger, I'd check through that wreckage for anything useful. It's back to Jellyfish Fields for me.
I really mean it this time, dude. No talking, no singing, and no way I'm taking off my Tough Man Championship belt.
That's it, Larry. You give me no choice but to invoke my greatest singing powers. Prepare yourself. Oh, there! Once were two fellows who met at the beach. One needed a belt that seemed out of reach. It had a big letter that would open a treasure. But the big guy who wore it didn't want to remove it. So SpongeBob decided to sing him this song. If you think I'll give up, boy, are you wrong!
Okay, that's enough. You want my belt so bad, then you'll have to win it the same way I did, in the Tough Man Arena. Just climb on board when you think you're ready, tough guy. The rules are real simple. We get a short amount of time to bust stuff up. The person with the highest score at the end wins the belt. But I'm warning you, anything goes. Got any questions? Then let the battle begin! You've got a lot of heart, little dude. The championship belt is yours. Time for a kelp smoothie!
The time has come for you to join my ghostly crew!
Fear not, my little friend. Remember what the book said? The treasures you have found will protect you from his magic.
Show some respect for your new captain!
See? His powers have become as limp as stewed seaweed.
Hey, go easy on me. I'm not the ghost I used to be, but who is?
Go, SpongeBob. Go, Self.
But do not be overconfident. You must still find the remaining treasures if you're going to break the Dutchman's spell over your friends.
You'll never find all my treasures.
Hey there, SpongeBob. Want to lend a hand?
Sure thing, Sandy. What can I do?
I joined up with Operation Clean Sweep. We're clearing up all the trash that floats down to Bikini Bottom. You can help me by rolling all the trash balls you see into the sewer, where they belong. There are 6 trash balls in all. And you can roll them with your reef blower.
Aye, aye, Sandy, you can count on me.
Thanks for all your help, SpongeBob. Now I can go to my tree dome and practice karate. There we go. Everything's spick and span the way it should be.
If it's cleaning you enjoy, then have I got the ship for you.
Stay back, you no good ghost wrangler, because I've got a knuckle sandwich with your name on it.
There's no need to resort to violence when I can just hypnotize you into obedience.
Begging your pardon, Captain, but we've located the little varmint who's been giving you all this trouble. Shall we continue moving our cargo down below?
Nay! Over the side! You don't stand a chance, SquarePants!
Look there. One of those cannons survived the fall from the Dutchman's ship. He may have given you the very thing you need to find your friends.
Now that's what I call a special delivery.
Why don't you jump inside it and see where it leads?
Gary! Patrick! Sandy! Well, I tried, but it looks like no one's here. I might as well go home.
Brace up, little fellow. Your friends are counting on you now more than ever. Only you can save them from the revenge of the Flying Dutchman.
You're right. I've come too far to let them down now.
Avast, matey! Who goes there? Be ye here to steal my booty?
Oh, believe me, I have no interest in touching your booty. I just want to find my friends and get them home.
You must mean those new crew members. The Dutchman's got all them fancy britches on his ship, while we're stuck out here in the graveyard.
Wow, that doesn't sound very fair to me.
To make matters worse, someone grabbed my booty while I was polishing this cannon. So now I'm stuck out here with no pay.
I wish I could do something to help you, Mr. Pirate, but I need to find a way to get past that other ship if I'm ever going to get my friends out of here.
I'll tell you what. You bring me one sack of booty, and I'll see what I can do to help you get across. Now that is one loaded booty sack. First, jump into the cannon. Then aim yourself. When you're ready, press the action button to fire yourself out of the cannon. Hold it right there, you thieving little scallop. Aren't you the one who's been digging around in my booty?
Oh, do you mean the booty stuffed in the crack of the ship? No, I don't know anything about that.
It was probably the Dutchman again. His booty is bigger than anyone's, but he still comes out here to get his hands on even more. He just can't get enough booty!
Will you let me use your cannon if I bring you some fresh booty?
Sure, if you can make it across that inferno to the next ship. I think I saw some just kinda sitting around over there, if you catch my drift. That sack was so big, I could barely get my hands around all that booty. Go ahead and use my cannon whenever you want. I'm going to hide this where the Dutchman can never find it. None shall pass, especially booty thieves.
No booty thieves here, just us pirates.
I could have sworn I saw someone who looked like you just before my booty was pinched. I used to love warming my booty in this place, but now I have no booty at all.
So if I understand this correctly, you wouldn't turn down some new booty, even if it came wrapped in dirty old canvas.
Are you kidding me? Everyone wants more booty, no matter what package it comes in. And I'd much rather be playing with my booty than guarding this old cannon. Wow, where did you get this? You must really know where to find the best booty. Keep an eye on that cannon for me, okay? You there! Stand fast and identify yourself.
Let me guess, you lost some booty, you want some more booty.
Gee, how did you know?
That's the way it is with you pirates. Booty this, booty that. Just stand aside and let me get you some more so you'll let me use your cannon, okay?
Okay. I'll just wait for you here. Thanks for the you-know-what. Bon voyage!
What took you so long, SpongeBob?
But I liked being a pirate.
Go get him, SpongeBob!
Nice going, SpongeBob!
Quick, Gary, over the side!
Well, well. So you've got my old flying dinghy over the side and all your friends onto it. But at least you won't get away from me. You'll be my cabin boy from now until the seas dry up.
Give it up, Dutchman. Your haunting nights are numbered.
I'll wipe the deck with you, Sponge.
Psst. Hello? I do not recommend that you antagonize him right now.
Who's afraid of a big bad Dutchman?
You don't understand. The book you borrowed from Squidward was not completely accurate. In fact, it was a little out of date.
Uh-oh.
According to the new edition, the treasures you gathered have made you mostly immune to the Dutchman's powers. But not completely immune. So be ready for a tough fight.
I'm not ready!
You don't stand a chance, SquarePants! Shiver me timbers!
Where are we going now, SpongeBob?
I don't know, Patrick. What do you think, Mr. Krabs?
To the Krusty Krab, everyone! For a feast like no other!
Oh, Mr. Krabs, I'm so happy!
Yee-haw! That's what I call a celebration!
Yay!
Yee-ha! Woo-hoo-hoo!
Of course, you know this is coming out of your paychecks.